What, Darby? Where is your boar, spearman? Fear you the boar and go so unprovided?
My lord, good morrow.
Good morrow, Catesby.
I look to see your honors at the council.
You may jest on, but by the holy rood, I hold my life too dear to jest at danger.
My lord, I hold my life as dear as you do yours.
Think you, but that I know our state secured, I would be so triumphant as I am? Lord Rivers, when that he rode hence from London, was jocund and supposed his state assured, and yet you see how soon his days o'ercast. This sudden stab of rancor, I misdoubt.
Aye, so, my lord, but shall we to the council?
So please you.
Come, bring forth the prisoner. Make haste, for the hour of death is expiate.
God keep Prince Edward from the pack of you. And not you are a damned bloodsucker.
Well, sir.
Bloody prison, fatal and ominous to noble peers. Within the guilty closure of thy walls, Richard II was here hacked to death. Now Margaret's curse has fallen on my head, standing by when as her son was stabbed. Then cursed she Hastings, then cursed she Buckingham, then cursed she Gloucester. Remember God to hear her prayers for them, as now for me.
Dispatch. The limit of your life is ours.
You live, but shall cry woe for this hereafter. Sir Richard Ratcliffe, let me tell you this. Thou art no more than fortune's instrument. And though thou seest thyself disposing death, thy own disposing may be like to mine.
Take we both the so same comfort now, that howsoe'er a curse may breed and breed, yet at the last it needs must spend itself. When all the roses in this ravaged land are plucked out, and every proud man slain, then at the last this dreadful storm may cease, and fury spent, as England shall have peace.
Good morrow, Lord. And now, Lord Chamberlain, knowest thou the cause why we are met today?
Why? To determine of the coronation. In God's name, say, when is the royal day?
Is all things fitting for that royal time?
It is. And wants but nomination.
Tomorrow, then, I guess, a happy time, my lord the prince being rested from his journey.
Who knows the lord protector's mind therein? Who is most inward with the noble duke?
Why, you, my lord, should soonest know his mind.
Why, my lord? We know each other's faces, but for our hearts, he knows no more of mine than I of yours, nor I no more of his than you of mine. Lord Hastings, you and he are near in love.
I thank his grace. I know he loves me well. But for his purpose in the coronation, I have not sounded him, nor he delivered his grace's pleasure any way therein. But you, my lords, may name the time, and in the duke's behalf, I'll give my voice, which I presume he'll take in gentle part.
And in good time, here comes the duke himself.
Oh, my noble lords and cousins, all good morrow. I have been long a sleeper. But I hope my absence doth neglect no great designs which by my presence might have been concluded.
Had you not come upon your cue, my lord, William Lord Hastings had pronounced your part. I mean your voice for crowning of the king.
Then, my lord Hastings, no man might be bolder. His lordship knows me well and loves me well.
I thank your grace.
My lord of Ely.
My lord.
When I was last in Holborn, I saw good strawberries in your garden there. I do beseech you, send for some of them.
Marry and well, my lord, with all my heart.
Cousin of Buckingham. Word with you?
Kate, we have sounded Hastings in our business. Finds the testy gentleman so hot as he would lose his head, they give consent.
Well, then we must needs proceed without him. I'll to the citizens while you and Catesby shall make dispose of Hastings at the council.
So withdraw you hence.
At Baynard's Castle, I'll meet your grace.
Good Norfolk, I pray one word.
We have not yet set down this day of triumph. Tomorrow, in my opinion, is too sudden, but I am not so well provided as else I would be were the day prolonged.
Where is the Lord Protector? I have sent for these strawberries.
His Grace looks cheerfully and smooth today. Some conceit or other likes him well when he doth bid good morrow with such a spirit. I think there's never a man in Christendom can lesser hide his love or hate than he. Or by his face, straight shall you know his heart.
What of his heart? Perceive you in his face by any likelihood he showed today?
Marry, but with no man here he is offended. For if he were, he would have shown it in his looks.
I pray you all, what do they deserve that do conspire my death with devilish plots of damned witchcraft, and that have prevailed upon my body with their hellish charms?
The tender love I bear your grace, my lord, makes me most forward in this noble presence to doom the offenders, whosoe'er they be. I say, my lord, they have deserved death.
Then be your eyes the witness of this ill. See how I am bewitched. Behold, mine arm is like a blasted sapling withered up. And this is Edward's wife. That monstrous witch that by her witchcraft thus hath marked me.
If she has done this thing, my gracious lord.
If! God protector of this damned strumpet. Tell me of it. Thou art a traitor. Off with his head. By St. Paul, I will not dine today, I swear, until I see the same. Some see it done. The rest that love me, come and follow me.
Woe, woe for England. Not a whit for me, for I, too fond, might have prevented this. Margaret, Margaret, now thy heavy curse is lighted on poor Hastings' wretched head.
Dispatch, my lord. The Duke would be at dinner. Make a short shrift. He longs to see your head.
Oh, bloody Richard. Miserable England. Come, lead me to the block. Bear him my head. They smile at me that shortly shall be dead.